Hi, welcome you all for Sri Lecture YouTube channel. So this is my fifth lecture on electromagnetic theory. So in previous lecture 4, we have discussed about differential length, surface area and differential volume for Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate system. In this lecture, we have discussed about spherical coordinate system and its differential length, differential surface and differential volume. So first one, so three coordinates of spherical coordinate systems are r, r, theta and phi. So where r is nothing but radius vector in meter, radius of the sphere in meter, and phi is like cylindrical coordinate, the angle between projection of radius vector on xy axis and x axis, it is nothing but azimuthal angle, and theta is nothing but angle between z axis and radius vector in degree and radiant or radiant. So here shows the diagram. So now consider this point. So this point is nothing but it is the three dimensional view. So this point is on surface of the sphere. So radius of the sphere is r. So now we need to draw the perpendicular line to the xy plane. So we get the point here. So now project this point towards the origin. It makes an angle phi. This phi is nothing but azimuthal angle. It mentioned in counterclockwise direction. So now we need to define the parameter theta. Theta is the angle between z axis and radius vector r. So angle between these two, this is the radius vector and this is the z axis. So angle between these two is polar angle. The name of this angle is polar angle. Polar angle. Polar angle. So now, so this polar angle represents in clockwise direction. So range of variable is, so r is radius of the sphere, only take positive value 0 to infinity, and phi is already known. In case of cylindrical, its value from 0 to 360, here also same value, and theta is the polar angle, it is the ranges from only its rotation is symmetric about the z axis. So for that the maximum rotation is around 180 degree. So the ranges are r is from 0 to infinity, theta is from 0 to 180 and phi is from 0 to 360, or this is represented as phi, this is represented as 2 pi. This is the range of variable in spherical coordinate. Next, differential volume in spherical coordinate system are, so now consider small volume highlighted in blue color. So here, so this is considered as r1, this dimension is up to this r1, this is r2. So now this length is simply changes in radius, it is a straight line, so simply we can write dr. Similarly, we can mention this area, curved area is changed with respect to theta. Here which changes is with respect to theta, this is t theta. So this is curved length, we can write the area, sorry, length as r into d theta. So similarly we need to mention third coordinate as, so third coordinate with respect to this surface. So here projection is there in the back end we have, so this is third surface, this is the curved length, this is with respect to d phi. So already we know with respect to d phi in cylindrical coordinate system we are having rho, length is rho into d phi, but already we know rho into d phi, but already know rho is the not a spherical coordinate. So for that we need to convert rho into corresponding spherical coordinate. So rho can be written as r into sin theta, rho can be written as r into sin theta. So here we have three dimensions are dr, sorry, r into d theta, dr r into d theta, then r in r sin theta into d phi, r we can write. So we can write the differential length dl as dr into a vector plus r into d theta into a theta and r sin theta into d phi into a phi. So we can write in a lot in detailed manner, we can define the two, rho 1 and rho 2. So this So rho 1, rho 2 are with respect to changes in d phi. So it's changes in here in rho 1 and rho 2. This is with respect to changes with respect to d rho, d phi and d rho. For that we can define this length as rho into d phi. Already we know we need to convert this spherical coordinate into cylindrical. We can write rho as r into sin theta into d phi. Similarly, so this length here, the radius r1, here the highest radius is r2. So this is the straight line. So we can write dr is nothing but simply r2 minus r1 is nothing but simply dr. This is the second dimension. And third one with respect to theta. So here theta 1, and here the length is, this is theta 2. This angle is nothing but d theta. So now with respect to theta, we have the this d theta with respect to change with respect to sphere. So for that we can write r into d theta. So now we get the three coordinates are, one coordinate is r into d theta, another coordinate is r sin theta into d phi, and third coordinate is dr. So from this we can write the dl vector. Suppose we need magnitude, means simply take square root of this. So dl vector magnitude, so we can return as square root of first term, that is dr the whole square, second term, plus r d theta the whole square, r into d theta the whole square, and third one plus r into sin theta into d phi the whole square. This is the length of the vector, magnitude of length of vector, and this is the differential area in spherical coordinate system. Now take small differential area. So here also we have six surfaces. So surface 1 and surface 2, surface 3 and surface 4, surface 5 and surface 6. We have totally six surface. So now with respect to ds, this is the surface 1. For surface 1 we have the dimension are r into d theta, here r sin theta into d phi. Here two parameter theta and phi is there. So unit vector is perpendicular to this two surface, that is third surface, theta and phi is there, third one is r. So corresponding to this we have ar is the unit vector. So simply multiply these two dimension, and along with we have two ar, one is along positive ar, another one is along negative. So we can multiply these two, means r squared sin theta d theta d phi into ar along positive ar direction. Similarly ds2 is equal to r squared into sin theta d theta d phi into minus ar along negative ar direction. And similarly we can write it for remaining two surfaces. So another one surface we have the dimension r sin theta, another one dimension simply we have dr. So here dr and d phi is there, a unit vector is perpendicular to this two plane, that is a theta. So one is along a theta, another one surface is along minus a theta. So similarly same magnitude with minus a theta. And third surface we have the dimension dr and r into d theta. Simply multiply, here variable r and d theta is there. So unit vector is along a phi. Here also we have two surfaces, one is along positive a phi, another one is negative a phi. Then we need volume. So for volume, simply multiply all the three coordinates along with the unit vector, that is we get dv vector, volume vector. Suppose we need the volume, in simply take modulus, then we get all the unit vector value become 1. So simply we get first dimension is dr into ar cap, that ar cap value is 1, and r d theta into a phi, that value is also 1, and this is a theta. Here a phi into a theta, here phi is there, so a cap, here phi. So while taking modulus, these three values are 1. Simply r into r become r squared sin theta dr d theta d phi. This is the volume. simply multiply these two, r squared into sine theta dr d theta d phi. This is the magnitude, simply put modulus, this is the volume. So in the next lecture, lecture 6, we are discuss about conversion from one coordinate to another coordinate, from Cartesian to cylindrical and spherical, from cylindrical to Cartesian and spherical, from spherical to Cartesian and cylindrical. This conversion we are discussed in next lecture 6. Thank you.